Students, welcome to our geography class. As you all know, both the weeks we will be focusing on revising what we have learned over the past weeks. This week we will focus mainly on revising our first chapter of geography that we have learned, that is the earth and the gratitude. This is the first chapter that we learned. Today we will learn the first part of this first chapter, the earth and the gratitude. The next part of this chapter we will revise in the next lecture, that is on Thursday. Let us revise what we have learned. We learned that our earth is made up of two factors, that is water and land. When I say water, it means all the water bodies in the world, for example oceans, seas, rivers, lakes, etc. will be termed as or will come under the water part. And next part is land. Land means continent. Continent means a huge piece of land is called as a continent. On the continents, you have various countries located. That means basically, our world is up of only two parts, water and land. Let us now learn the names of various oceans and land or continents of the world. Before we begin, let me tell you that there are five important water bodies on the earth or oceans on the earth. Those are Arctic Ocean, Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean and Southern Ocean. Whereas there are seven continents on the earth. These are North America, South America, Europe, Asia, Australia, Atlantic and Africa. You have to remember the names of the oceans as well as the continents. Also, you have to remember that there are five oceans in the world and seven continents of the world. Among them, the Pacific Ocean is the largest ocean in the world. We have learned the names of the oceans. Among them, the largest ocean of the world is the Pacific Ocean. Among that, among the continents, Asia is the largest continent of the world. All of us know we stay in the Asian continent, as country India lies in the Asian continent. So our continent, Asia continent, is one of the largest continent of the world. And compared to that, Australia is the smallest continent of the world. Let us focus on the earth size. Now all of us know we have four parts of the earth, that is North Pole, West part, South Pole and East part. Today we are going to learn the distance of the earth from North Pole to South Pole and from West to East. Let us go ahead by learning. So the distance from the North Pole to South Pole, that means the distance from the North Pole to South Pole of the earth is 12,714 kilometers. You can imagine how huge our earth is. That means starting from North Pole to South Pole, the distance of the earth is 12,714 kilometers, and that of distance from west to east, that means starting from west to east, this from year to year, the distance of the earth is 12,075 kilometers. This is the distance of, you can see over here, distance is this. So from this distance, you will realize that the distance from the west to east is more as compared to distance from North Pole to South Pole. That is, from west to east, the distance is 12,756 kilometers, and that from North Pole to South Pole, it is only 12,714 kilometers. So that means the distance from west to east is more as compared to distance from north to south. Now, what is a globe? I think all of you must have seen a globe in your school or maybe in a library, etc., or maybe in notebooks also. Globe is a miniature model of the earth, is called as globe. Now you have to study about earth. Obviously, you cannot bring the entire earth in the class. It is not possible. And therefore, some geologists have made a model, a look-alike of globe, and that is called as a globe. That means a miniature, mean a small. The word miniature means small. So a small model, a small look-alike of the earth is called as a globe. That means this is how exactly our earth looks like. and that is called as a globe. Let us know about the angular distance. Location of any place is determined by its center. That means the center of the earth is very important to locate any place on the earth. For example, it is from center of the earth that we have four directions, that is north, west, south and east. That means from center we always count the directions of the earth. Equator becomes the central line that divides the earth into two equal parts. This is our equator. If you do like this, if you hold the earth like this, you will realize this is our equator, which divides the earth into two parts. That is North Pole or Northern Hemisphere and Southern Hemisphere. All the angles on the earth are measured with respect to the equator. That means it is from the equator we have to count the angles on the earth. You can see over here, this is our equator. All of us must have used this protractor in your geometry or in your maths class. This is how we calculate the various latitudes or degrees on the earth. Before moving on, let us understand the meaning of parallels of latitudes. Circles created at some angular distance from center of the earth are parallel to each other. These are called as parallels of latitudes. Now, I think in a lower standard in maths class, we have understood the meaning of parallels. Parallel line means line which do not meet each other or do not intersect each other are called as parallels. You can see over here, these lines, you can see over here on the earth, do they intersect each other? No, these lines do not intersect or do not meet each other. Therefore, they are called as parallels of latitudes. In simple language, the slipping lines on the earth are called as parallels of latitudes. Now, the degrees are measured from the equator. You can see, you have to hold this protector on the equator. You will realize equator lies on the 0 degree. These are the various numbers you can see exactly there on the earth also. So, if you hold the protector on the equator, equator lies at what degree? 0 degree. So, if you have to count the parallels on the earth, we have to start counting from the equator. As you go upward, you realize we reach 90 pole exactly is the north pole. So, our north pole lies on the 90 degree and equator lies on the 0 degree. Therefore, equator is the largest parallel. Just now, we learned about the distance from west to east is more and then that of the north to south. So, that is the equator. This equator is one of the important parallel or latitude because it is a slipping line. It is called as latitudes and it is the largest latitude or parallel on the earth. You can see over here, just now we saw about equator lies on the 0 degree. We have to go count upward. You can see the various numbers shown over here. We reach 90 pole and that is the north pole. Now, equator divides the earth into two equal parts, that is northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Look over in this picture, you will realize this is our equator. Equator divides the earth into two parts. This is the north pole, upper part is called as north pole and the down part is called as the south pole. This picture we will learn in the next video. We will focus first only on equator. We will see this is the equator which divides the earth into two equal parts. These two parts are northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. And equator divides the earth into two poles. These two poles are north pole and south pole. You can see the white color shown over here. It is completely covered with ice throughout the year. Therefore, it is shown in white color. The two important poles are north pole and south pole. The two important parts divided by the equator are northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Students, we will stop here. We will first complete this part of our lesson. The next part of our lesson we will revise in the next video, that is on Thursday. Now, with this video, all of you must be knowing you will used to get assignment in your test mods. But this time you will not get your assignment in the test mods, but you will be given a small test that you have to solve in something called as my test. As you open your LMS, you have something about my content, my tutorial, my assignment. Below my assignment, you have something called as my test. You have to click on that my test, and that is where you will be able to view your test. It is my request for you to please watch this video carefully and solve the answers given to you in the test. Thank you.